Hunter Dustman, first things first, just let's discuss coming into this game, the rivalry. What was the preparation like? Was it any different, the lead up this week, compared to, I guess you would say, a regular football game?
It's just another week. We don't we didn't really prepare any differently. Just prepared for what we thought they were going to bring us, and then just executed throughout the week.
So as this game plays out, the Jacks get an interception late in the first half, puts you in position for what is a career-long field goal here at South Dakota State. It's a long one. I know you warmed up. I know you made it from that distance beforehand. But what's going through your mind as you go out there for the final play of the half?
I honestly didn't know how far it was. So I just like went out there, looked down. I was like, oh, this is pretty straight. So let's just hit it straight.
Timeout. You didn't know how long it was?
No, I don't. I don't look at the yardages unless we're like really back there. So I don't, like, I have no idea what I'm hitting.
Well, I have to ask, it was a career-long field goal, Hunter. It was 49 yards. Isn't that kind of really back there?
Yeah, I guess. You say it like that.
I'm just curious, because in golf, you know if you're going to use a 4-iron or a 7-iron or a 9-iron, and it doesn't matter to you.
Not in a dome, because okay. I don't really have to like look at the wind or anything like that. So if the ball's in the middle of the field, I just hit the same ball every time.
Okay, walk me through the process of getting the offside on USD and getting you 5 extra yards there closer on that other field goal try.
I wanted to hit a 52, so.
You were mad about it.
A little bit.
You said it doesn't look at distance.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, how does that work? You don't look at distance, but you knew that?
I knew it was a 52 because I saw the 40-yard line numbers when I was running out there, so.
Well, Hunter, what does it mean to get a team win like this on the road against a top five team, to come on the road and play like this? What's it mean to you and your teammates?
Oh, it feels great. And I mean, I think it just shows like the preparation throughout the week. And everybody knew that we were just going to have to execute at the end of the day. So it really feels good.
Hunter, congratulations. Thanks for your time.
Thank you very much.
Jadon, first off, congratulations.
Thank you very much.
All right. Let's talk about you being a South Dakotan. And you've been in this building twice. Things haven't gone the way of the Jacks. So to come down here, play the way you did, you have to be incredibly proud of your teammates and yourself today.
Yes, sir. And actually, I'm going to correct you. I think this might have been my 11th time playing in this building. myself, I've had great success in here. I know the last few times the Jacks have been here, we fell short. But, you know, we came in here, put all that in the past. We just got to keep moving ahead in the future, and this is a new team, this is a new program this year, and I think we showed it today.
Yes, thank you for clarifying. It is not the third time you overall have played here. I was just referring to your Jackrabbit tenure, but that is an important denotation because you South Dakotans, again, with the high school championships here, you guys have a long history in this building.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, coming here never gets any easier. I hate the color red, especially. These bleachers are so ugly, but, you know, being from South Dakota, coming in here, it just means a lot to come away with a win in the fashion that we did it.
How excited were you when you heard the call of the reverse?
Oh, I was very excited. You know, that play, we had a pretty good feeling it was going to work. And Isaiah being the back that he is, you know, they bite hard on him when he gets the ball. He had a perfect pitch. And then it was basically a walk-in for me. I got to give a lot of credit to the guys up front and Mark and Jackson out there on the outside.
See, we talk so much about how you wide receivers block. Gronowski's trying to get honorary denotation into the 605 Hogs the way he's throwing blocks today.
Absolutely. You know, he runs the ball and he throws the ball, but that's not all he does. He's a big boy out there, so we like to use him in many ways.
Talk about being in this building. What can you say about the turnout of Jackrabbit Nation? There was a lot of blue here in Vermilion today.
Yeah, it was awesome. We came in here with the mentality that it didn't have to be close. And I'm a little bit spiteful, if I'm going to be honest. We wanted this building to go dead silent for the Yotes and all Jackrabbit fans cheering for us.
What was it like to watch Chase Mason and Angel Johnson on that last drive?
It was awesome. Those guys work their tail off every day. They're special guys coming from the same hometown. It's pretty cool to see the success that they're having.
Jadon, all this talk about this game, a top five matchup, and all we have next week is the Dakota Marker and a top 10 matchup as your brother chimes in there on the video. Jackson, hello, number 10. But Jadon, next week, back home, sellout crowd, Dakota Marker. These things never get any easier, do they?
They do not. Every game we've had this year has almost been a really, really big matchup, you know, a top 10 matchup for us. And I think that's something that we're used to, you know, the past few years. We're always playing really, really good teams, you know, and we never really get a break, which I think is a big reason that we're the team we are right now. We're built for this. Back home at Dana Jay against the the Bison. It's going to be a good one.
Jaden, congratulations. Go enjoy this.
Thank you.
All right. Congratulations, Dalys. And let us talk about the last couple of weeks, because there's been some injuries to your fellow cornerbacks. Mm-hmm. You and Deshaun, I don't think you came off the field last week. I think Deshaun was out for a couple of plays today and came right back in.
Yeah.
What is the mindset of you and Deshaun trying to take all this on yourselves that, hey, we're going to represent and stand up for some of those guys who weren't available today?
I mean, going throughout the week, we kind of know what the task is at hand. And our coach, he prepares us for that, you know, all the reps during the week, you know, just getting our legs there. And we know what task is at hand. You know, we got to be ready for that work. So, and we do it for our fellow corner, Steve. He's out, so he's going to be back with us very soon. So we were just doing it for him, doing it for the whole corner room. And we were ready to take on that.
Carter Bell is one of the best wideouts the University of South Dakota has ever produced. He's an exceptional player. He had one catch today. Walk me through what you guys have to do from an approach to try to handle somebody as talented as him.
You know, every week, you know, especially with our conference in the Missouri Valley, we see a bunch of great, talented receivers. So, you know, every week we highlight who the good receivers are that we got a key, and we just, you know, it goes to film study and the work throughout the week, you know, just seeing that scout. And just knowing that we have to guard a good receiver every week. And we're just used to that, you know, manning up, you know, taking on those good, talented receivers. So, I mean, we're used to it, though. Like I said, in the Missouri Valley, there's all kinds of good receivers. So every week we're just ready for it.
Dalys, I want you to take me through the one long ball that was thrown over the top of your head where you reached initially and it just went over your head. Then as it got to Bell, as your hand came through, you're able to break up that pass. Tell me what you saw and what happened.
You know, I was in my back pedal, and the receiver was pushing up on me, so I knew it was going to be a deep route. So I opened up ready for the post, and we talked at halftime. You know, I jumped a little bit earlier than I should have, so I'm just glad I got a little tip on the ball, and then it was enough to get the ball out of the receiver's hands.
How proud are you of the offense and what they were able to accomplish today?
Hey, I was very proud of them. It's always good to have a great offense on the other side of the ball. And all the defensive staff, all we talk about is just if we get a stop, we can give it back to our offense, and they're always going to score some points. It's great to have such a dynamic offense that you can give the ball to, and they're going to score some points.
Dalys, you had the big play to seal it up in Fargo last week to bring the Dakota marker back to Brookings. Now the marker's on the line in Brookings next Saturday. From one rivalry game to another, how excited are you for a sellout crowd of 19,000 at Dana J. Dykhouse Stadium?
Man, these are the games you want. These are the games you want. So, I mean, we're excited for it. We're going to enjoy this win tonight, and then we're going to get back to square one and get ready for the next opponent.
Dalys, thank you. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Jimmy, first and foremost, congratulations. A complete victory here on all sides of the football by your team.
Yeah, our guys came out. They were ready. We practiced and prepared really hard this week, and just glad that it resulted in that type of performance, because I think these last 3 weeks we've really overemphasized just the preparation and taking that serious, and they've taken that very seriously, and because of it, the result is the result.
I know you're going to downplay this, but there are people watching and listening who follow along with these games, and their hearts are into it, and they see you get off to a little bit of a slow start. Coyotes have a 3-0 lead after a quarter, and they start to worry, and they start to fret a little bit, but there was no sense of that on your sideline. Why is that?
We got great leadership. The kids kind of been through every single scenario in their time here now, and they have confidence in one another, and they believe in the preparation, and the culture is strong at South Dakota State.
Isaiah Davis, 69 yards on 17 carries, but as you took the lead on that long drive in the second quarter, there's a couple of times on third down that there's one more defender than you can account for, and he's got to make a play, and he just finds a way to do that.
Yeah, Isaiah is consistent at that. If you leave him, there's always, if you block it up right, there's going to be one unblocked player, and there was multiple at times, and not just Isaiah. There was multiple running backs that made something out of nothing, and we're blessed to have what I believe is the greatest or the best running back group in the country at this level. And so Amar had a big night, and Angel when he got in, and he's really good too. So proud of those guys, proud of the group, proud of the O-line, and we're going to continuously get better. If you guys got any pointers on how to not jump off sides, I'll take it. I promise you we work on things. But that's a huge win tonight.
Well, that's probably the most frustrating part of anything that happened today was that you had three wide receiver false starts amid the seven penalties.
Yeah, it got loud over here for a little bit, and we just got to be composed and continue to compete. And I felt like we did that today. No matter where we got as far as behind the sticks or where we were at, we just kept playing in the moment, and we got great leadership to help us lead us through those tough times.
We can talk a lot about players on the defensive side of the ball, but Dyshawn Gales and Dalys Beanum played, I think, every snap last week at corner, and they almost played every snap today. We saw Gales come out for a couple of plays. For those two guys, with some of the receivers they had to defend, Carter Bell's one of the best in the Missouri Valley, for them to be able to do what they did the last 2 weeks, I mean, that is very impressive stuff, Jimmy.
Yeah, I think our guys were really locked in just to the game plan in general. I think the longest pass was 19 yards, and the longest run was 7 yards. So anytime that you can do that, you're going to have success defensively, eliminating the big plays, and you just got to get through teams' openers and settle back in. I felt like we did that tonight.
How good was Hunter Dustman today?
He was great, and he's just a great player. He's consistent, and if there's no wind, he can make it from. He was making it pregame at 61. I wasn't going to test that. You guys would think I'm nuts, but yeah, he was hitting them great all night.
What were you proudest of today?
The finish. You know, our guys at halftime weren't satisfied, and I don't even remember the exact score at half, but 17-3, and our guys wanted to. This was personal to them, and it's a rivalry, and it's meant to be competitive, and our guys responded in every way.
All right, so you get out of here with a win, and now you turn around and you have another rivalry game, sellout crowd at Dana J. Dykal Stadium against North Dakota State, and it's just another week in the Jackrabbit football program, isn't it?
Yeah, we're excited about this one, and we're gonna not worry about North Dakota State until tomorrow, and we'll reset our focus and keep moving forward.
Jimmy, last point. This was a sellout crowd, over 9,000. There was a lot of yellow and blue in this building
today. Yeah, it was great. It was great. We could hear the support. Just keep coming. I'm excited for a sold-out Dana J next week at home. And if you watch this, just create some noise when they're on offense and give us some form of an advantage defensively. This is a tough team that we're going to play at home. And we're going to enjoy this one tonight, but we know who's coming to Brookings, and we need to bring our best.
Jimmy, congratulations.
Thank you.